Before we get into the reviews, big shout out to all of my patrons on Patreon. Love you guys. Thank you so much for the support. If you'd like to request a movie for me to review on my channel, check out my Patreon page and choose the tier that works best for you. With all that said, let's go ahead and get into the Patreon reviews. First up is a request from Darius, also known as Boomer, for a new film called Shifter. The story follows a young woman who experiences painful and gruesome side effects after an experiment with time travel goes wrong. If you follow my channel for any length of time, something that I talk about a lot is how much I love indie horror films. I really wanted to like Shifter. There's a kernel of a good idea here, but there's not enough to sustain a full-length feature. If anything, this should have been a short. The main character has no personality. I couldn't attach myself to her. I really didn't care what happened to her. She's very one note, and I don't feel that it's necessarily the actress's fault. It's just, she's really poorly written. And so is the rest of the film. It doesn't really make a whole lot of sense. There doesn't really seem to be much of a narrative here. There's a couple of cool scenes of horror, I guess, but the CGI is pretty bad. I feel like they should have tried to do some kind of practical effects or not do them at all. And for a film that's touted as being body horror, I really didn't see much body horror except for the painful eyesore of CGI. For me, this is an obvious skip it. This is one of the worst films I've seen this year so far. Up next is a request from Ben Grimm for the 2011 film, Detention. The story follows a copycat killer named after the movie villain Cinderella, who stalks a student body at Grizzly Lake High School. A group of co-eds band together to survive while serving detention. There's also aliens and time travel. I'm a bit conflicted as to how I feel about this film. On one hand, there's a really cool aesthetic, and there's definitely a vision for this film. There's not really a point where you feel like you can really take a minute to kind of soak in what's happening. The story is constantly pulling from pop culture, from a lot of 80s and 90s horror films and sci-fi movies. But I personally felt like it was a little too on the nose with its homage to pop culture, especially when it's referring to The Breakfast Club. There's also too many storylines. I can't really keep track of what I'm supposed to be paying attention to. What is the main story? It just feels like it's all over the place and that there's a lot of ideas that just got crammed into one film because reasons. I feel like there's a very niche audience for this film, and I'm definitely not that audience because for me, this is a very low weekend rental. Up next is a request from Thomas Mariani for the found footage film, Afflicted. The film follows two best friends who see their trip of a lifetime take a dark turn when one of them is struck by a mysterious affliction. Now in a foreign land, they race to uncover the source before it consumes him completely. I really enjoyed this film a lot. Our main character, Derek, played by Derek Lee, who's also the director, did a great job. For those who haven't seen Afflicted yet, I don't want to spoil exactly what he's afflicted with or how he gets it, because that's part of the fun about this film, is discovering along with him and his friend what's going on with him, why all of a sudden he has these superpowers. It's fun to go on that journey. I thought the effects were pretty decent, especially for pretty low budget, but my one issue, and it's mostly an issue with the found footage genre as a whole, in some found footage films it makes sense for the people to continue to record. In this film, it doesn't really make a whole lot of sense, it just seems kind of odd, and that's the one thing that just kind of takes me out of it in certain situations. Other than that, I would give Afflicted a high weekend rental. It's definitely worth checking out at least once. And last up is a request from Adam Thomas, which is Stakeland from 2010. The story follows Martin, who was a normal teenager before the country collapsed in an empty pit of economic and political disaster. A vampire epidemic has swept across what is left of the nation's abandoned towns and cities, and it's up to Mister, a death-dealing rogue vampire hunter, to get Martin safely north to Canada, the continent's new Eden. Stakeland Land is a very ambitious film. There's a lot of world building, which I really appreciated. It kind of reminded me of the Walking Dead comic books, the way that the group would travel from place to place. The thing is that the group only stays in one place for maybe 5 minutes in the runtime of the film, and then will move to another place. But that keeps repeating over and over and over again, to the point where you never really get attached to anyone that they meet, and they try to set up these really emotional moments, but because they haven't really earned that, I don't feel the weight of any of those losses, I don't feel the actual stakes of those circumstances. It's a fine film, but I feel like it should have been more of a TV series. There was too much crammed in for one single film, which is why I have to give this one a weekend rental. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. If you'd like to support the channel even more, check out my Patreon page. Link is in the description below as well as in the pinned comment. Thank you so much for coming by, and I'll see you guys on the next video.